I said we clearly saw that with Brandon Jennings. We played in Italy. So going from about 25 in high school to, I mean, roughly under 10.
Yeah, it just is the way the game's played, and probably a lot of people think Brandon Jennings had a bad year in Italy. But I think for a rookie to have a year like that in Italy, that's not bad at all on a very good team. And at the same time, he got experience that I don't think he could have had in college. Especially he was a one-and-done guy, and it's not like he was going to graduate. And I think that was a smart choice. He made some money. He played on a really good team. He played in the EuroLeague. And I think that helped him. Like that really good rookie year he had with the Bucks.
All right, and I guess I guess one more question before we take a music break, and we'll get you out of here for your for class to finish up before you graduate. What has been your most memorable moment here at AU?
That's tough. I think on the court, I'm not going to forget the Lafayette game. I think that's going to stay with me. You really can't forget that. I think the best moment was kind of like beating DePaul. That was my first game here. And it was just a great feeling being able to beat a Big East team, you know. But I think I'm never going to be able to forget Lafayette game in the playoffs here. That's something I'm never going to forget, and it's definitely going to stay with me. Kind of like I was talking to Coach Jones about it. It's always going to be there in the back of your mind, no matter what. And he's telling about his last game, and he always remembers that. It's just it's tough when you really want something that bad, and you put it all on the line, and you know it's your last chance. No, just that's kind of like Larry Bird going out with loss, and I mean he hated that. He always talks about that, and it's just you don't want to go out that way. You want to win a championship, and I feel like though I won two championships in college, I didn't really win one. You know, it's just the way life is, and I think that's it. It's just got to move on and do your best to get over it, but you can't really forget it. It was one of those things. Then off the court, I feel like being able to graduate and just moving on with your life, that's a huge thing for everyone. Just being able to graduate, I think nowadays, kids don't really, it's like, oh, I'm going to come back to school later. Like, very few kids do that. And it's hard when you take a break to actually come back to school. And, like, I admire Vince Carter for doing that, coming back to UNC and just graduating, but most of the guys don't do it. And then you end up with guys being broke in the NBA. They have no idea what to do with their money. And when they're broke, what do? They still have to play in the NBDL, like Antoine Walker, for a couple thousand dollars. So you don't want to be in that situation. I think you really got to realize that though you might not make $1 million a year right now, but when you get out of college, if you actually split those years and the amount you could have made, I think it's not worth it. Just kind of like skip through college. So off the court, definitely getting a degree from American University is just the biggest thing for me.
All right, so that will do it for our interview. And I got to say, we wish you the very best of success, Vlad, going into, first graduating.
Yeah.
And then whatever happens, whether playing in the States or playing in Europe. Once again, Vlad Mulvaney, American University's own. Thank you once again for coming on to the show. And when we come back, we will definitely talk about more of the NHL, crazy news in college basketball world, and predictions for the rest of the playoffs and baseball news. So once again, you're listening to Fanatic Radio on WVAU.
It is in the building. Yeah! Alright, already the show goes on all night. Till the morning we dream so long. Anybody ever wonder when they would see the sun? Just remember when you come up.
All on your soul and put whips up on your back. They be lying through they teeth, hope you slip up off your path. I don't switch up, I just laugh. Put my kicks up on they desk, unaffected by they threats. Then get busy on they ass. See, that's how that shit tell me, man. That's how my daddy raised me. That glittering may not be gold, don't let nobody play me. If you are my homeboy, you'll never can't trust. So even if they ban, I still never slow my plans up. For the father that's there, three in the air for the kids in the ghetto, four for the kids that don't wanna be there, none for the people trying to hold him back, five in the air for the teacher not scared to tell those kids that's living in the ghetto that they're holding back that the world is theirs. Yeah, yeah, the world is yours. I was once that little boy, terrified of the world. Now I'm on a world tour. I will give up everything, even start a world war for these ghetto girls and boys. I'm rapping around the world for Africa to New York, Haiti then I detour, Oakland out to Oakland. Guys are stripped to Detroit, say hip-hop only destroy. Tell them, look at me, boy, I hope your son don't have a gun and never be a D-boy. What you've been through, no matter what you into, no matter what you see when you look outside your window, brown grass or green grass, picket fence or barbed wire, never ever put them down. You just lift your arms higher, raise them till your arms tired, let them know you there, that you struggling, surviving, that you gon' persevere. Yeah, ain't nobody leaving, nobody going home, even if they turn the lights out, the show is going on. Alright,
sober girls around me, they be acting.